You're welcome to another episode of Reason TV. Today we have a very special guest who will be speaking to us about the Reason Youth Project. Welcome, sir.
Thank you very much.
I would like you to introduce yourself to our viewers out there.
Okay, I am the vision behind Reason TV and essay to the governor of Enugu State of Youth Affairs. My name is Emeka Asoba.
Sir, the Reason TM project actually has been going on for quite a while now. What is the progress?
Can you
focus on the progress so far you guys have recorded?
Remember that it was the late Miles Moroder said, when the purpose is not known, abuse is inevitable. So the purpose of Reason TV is clear. The purpose is to promote values and skills so that we can reach out to families, reach out to young people who can, through this media platform, you know, get empowered without actually coming to Enugu. At Enugu Youth Development Center, somebody can watch all over. People are calling from all over the world. People are commending what we are doing, and that is the purpose of this. To see that we reach out, use values and skills as veritable tools, empowerment tools to reach out to our people. And I tell you, we are seeing a lot of results. Yes.
You know, every business actually faces one challenge or the other. So far, what have been the challenges using projects since the government?
Okay, we are actually trying to improve. There is always room for improvement. For instance, we are trying to see, get more media tools that will help us to also continue to reach out to our fans who are always watch us on this Reason TV, okay? And also, I always say that young people, what it takes to reach out to young people. Remember, we are doing programs. We are going to communities. I was in Abuja for Light of Nigerian project, and my friends were telling me, oh, what you're doing in Enugu? Most of us in Abuja, well, they don't do this, but they will have offices and they have funding and all that. So I think part of the challenges we have is funding, okay? Poor funding, especially in the eastern Nigeria, where we are still trying to grow in that dimension, okay? We're not enjoying the level of funding that somebody in Abuja or Lagos or Port Harcourt enjoys in the area of capacity building. So we are still growing, and I think our people are coming up gradually. Funding is a major one of the major challenges, and we know where. That's why we always teach what we call money making platforms, teach strategies so that young people who benefit from what we are doing. If you go behind the scene, you see that people who actually benefit from what we are doing, they are the people also supporting what we are doing. For instance, through the platform, the NGO that we partner with Wisdom Foundation Programs, over 33 Nigerian youth have been sent abroad, and some of them are getting. In fact, one just arrived in US last week, and he was so excited. He was on Facebook, you know, praising and thanking Burism and all that, and you know, for being a reason why he began that journey, and today he's in the United States. So we make sure that we keep encouraging our people to develop entrepreneurial skills so that they can also support what we are doing.
Benefits.
For instance, you see, some of them through Burism, we're talking about agriculture. Agriculture. If you come to my state now, come to different parts of a lot of people are now aware about agriculture, so they need to go back to the farm. And it is amazing. I always say that the meat, the maize I'm even eating in my house today, it was something that was produced from Burism farms. Because we have Burism farms, and young people are now beginning to go back to agriculture. Just last week, we took a number of young people to Abuja for Light Up Nigerian project. In fact, they benefited, they were licensed. They were licensed. As I'm talking with you now, they are going to be repairers, installers, distributors, and many of them are making money already. If you talk, if you come in the area of digital marketing, we bring people like some of our partners. I always talk about Stella, Victor, and even Ojobe, young people who are making money through digital platforms. They come to our center, to Enugu Youth Development Center, and they teach young people how to become self-reliant. And you see young people who probably came because they wanted 30,000. But when you are in politics, that is a wrong perception. When you are in government, people assume that, especially young people, that maybe you have, there is this flow of money. So when they come to me, I'm looking for 10,000. Mecca, can you give me 50,000, 30,000? I say, okay, I may not be able to give everybody fish, but I can create a platform that can teach you how to fish. So what I'm doing is that young people are being taught how to fish. And I tell you, they are making 500,000, 1 million, and it is amazing. People are becoming young millionaires just because they are part of the race.
Young millionaires. There are a lot of people out there actually like me, like me. I want to be young millionaires. I want to benefit from this system. So how do they go about?
Go back to agriculture. Now, as a young girl with all her beauty, you can be more beautiful when you are at the farm, because the farm is a place to show your beauty. Is a place to show. In fact, you will be more beautiful in the eyes of people when you are producing what people are eating. Are you with me? You'll be more beautiful, people, because if you're only beautiful, some people may see it as laziness. Some people can see laziness even when you are beautiful. But when you are at the farm, they see the real beauty, because they say, "Ah, what a beautiful farm! What a beautiful young girl who is a farmer." So you see, what a beautiful graduate, what a good, a young boy who is a farmer also. So we are taking people back to farm. So I encourage you to go back to farm. I encourage you also to understand the internet. The internet is a big platform for money making. People are making money, whether we like it or not. The Bitcoin is over $9,000. As at this morning, the rate was $9,600. I mean, one Bitcoin, over 3 point something million. So please, I want to beg you, not only you, tell your friends, tell everyone who loves to grow, move to the next level. Everyone that want to move, go back to agriculture, go back to digital marketing, know about the internet. Do you know that many young people are analog? How can you be analog in this generation? Even the God you serve is a digital God. God is no man, God is digital. Can you imagine? God is in heaven, but he's talking to everybody at the same time. Is that not a digital God? So everyone must go digital. So it's amazing. I'm so excited what you're saying. And I'm in a state where we have a governor. A governor that is so much supporting. He has support. As I'm talking with you now, this December, we are reaching out to 3 senatorial zones sponsored by His Excellency to make sure that what we are doing in Enugu, people can see positive outcome. Especially in capacity building, character development, agriculture, digital technology, and production also. You know why China is China? China is China because China is producing. Nigeria is Nigeria because Nigerians are consuming. A consuming nation can never compete favorably in the Committee of Nations. So we must encourage our Nigerian young people graduate to become producers. So at Burism, we are producing. At Burism, we are in agriculture. At Burism, we are in character development. At Burism, we are in digital technology. At Burism, we are in everything good.
So to our fellow viewers out there, you've heard it all. I don't know about you, but me, I want to be a young millionaire. So I'll advise you all to take this opportunity and join the Burism Youth Empowerment Project. See you later. Same station, same time. Thank you.